Hello and welcome to this day after edition of the 9-Yard Line here on WGN News Now. I'm Larry Hawley. As we take a look back at quite a painful night for the Bears against the Commanders on Thursday at Soldier Field. It had the look of two teams that are toward the bottom of the NFL as neither was able to pull away over the course of 60 minutes of defensive football. Like it has a lot lately though, it ended painfully for the Bears, who lost 12-7 to Washington. So let's go ahead and get to it with tight end Cole Kmet. He kicks it off by summing up the most frustrating part of the loss, and his answer is no surprise.
Not scoring. I mean, yeah, no, it's tough. I mean, that's how you win games in this league. You got to score touchdowns, and not getting field goals. But, I mean, you know, can't be turning the ball all over either. So when we get those opportunities, I mean, even, you know, fourth and one at the goal line there, you know, we got to punch that in.
Cole is certainly right about that, because when you fail to get a point in the red zone over the course of a game, things usually don't work out. It didn't, as the Bears got to the red zone three times on Thursday night against the Commanders, but didn't come out with a single point. That would prove to be the difference in the game, as Washington squeezed down two field goals and a late touchdown off a turnover by the Bears to win by 5 points. The defeat is easily the most frustrating of the first four for the Bears in 2022, who showed all the signs of a rebuilding team on a chilly night at Soldier Field. But Matt Eberflus is trying to put things in perspective as the team heads for a weekend off, pointing out what the team has to do moving forward in order to keep this loss from spiraling.
Yeah, just communication. You know, we're communicating with the staff, and then the staff's communicating with the players. You know, it's a good this mini bye before we go on this 7-game stretch here that we have coming up. We have to do a good job of keeping everything in perspective. You know, that we are growing, we are getting better, and really working on with each individual player. You know, that's our whole part of the plan. Hey, this is what you're doing well. This is what you need to improve on. Here's our plan to get that done. And I think when you have a mindset of growth that way, you will improve and you will get better. And then our units will function better.
So the Bears have now settled in the third in the NFC North, where at least they're ahead of the Lions before play starts for the rest of the division this weekend. The Vikings remain in first place with the Packers just behind at 3-2. Now it's time to start going through the emotions of a Bears loss to the Commanders on Thursday night. And at least we have one side of the ball to smile about. The defense did everything they could, or could be expected of them, against Washington on Thursday. They allowed just 214 total yards on the evening, and just 86 through the air, as they also collected 3 sacks. The Commanders only reached the end zone in the fourth quarter after a fumbled punt. We'll talk about that in a bit. Cornerback Jalen Johnson, who returned to the lineup for the first time in 3 games last night, discussed what he believes helped the defense produce a strong effort.
Just starting faster, getting things going top to bottom, just really executing in the beginning. I thought we've always been a good third or fourth quarter team, but we gave up too many points in the second quarter, I feel like, throughout this year. So, I mean, just doing the little things right throughout the duration of the game, and we talked about sustained execution. I feel like that's what we had throughout that game.
So there is a lot to frown about in this game, but we won't start this part of the segment with the offense, but rather special teams. For a second time in 3 games, rookie Velus Jones Jr. fumbled a punt in opposing territory in the fourth quarter. This time it came inside the Bears' 10-yard line and led to the Commanders' winning score. Jones also had a fumble against the Giants in Week 4 that hindered the Bears' chances of rallying to tie that game. Of course, the next two are from the Bears' efforts in the red zone. The first is in the second quarter when Justin Fields and tight end Ryan Griffin couldn't connect on what would have been a wide-open touchdown to the end zone. Instead, the ball went over Griffin's hand, as you can see there, and incomplete. The Bears were later stopped on fourth down. Then the final offensive play of the night for the Bears, Darnell Mooney appeared to get his hands on the ball over the goal line on fourth down, which would have been a score, but he couldn't hold on. And by the time he came down with it, he ended up outside the goal line, sealing the Bears' fate. Here's Mooney on that ill-fated play.
Seeing the ball at the beginning, kind of lost his light. And, just tried to catch the light at the end of the day. And, just couldn't see it. But at the end of the day, on that period of time, I'm literally talking to myself, like, please give me this ball, give me this ball. And I just gotta close the game for us. If I want to be that player, I want to be that guy for our team, I gotta make that play.
Now the OMG moment of the game might have been a few moments where the Bears and their fans said exactly that, OMG, because Justin Fields was hit early, often, and hard. Washington had a total of 12 quarterback hits on Fields. Five of those were for sacks. Two hits at the end of the first half fed Fields slowly making his way back to the locker room for the break. And even on his touchdown throw to Dante Pettis, he took a few minutes to stay down after taking a major shot after the throw. Despite all that, Fields still got the Bears in position to win it with a 39-yard run in the final minute. But it was all for naught. Fields said after the game he was hurting but was more frustrated after another possible win slipped away.
Everybody's feeling this way. Everybody's mad. I mean, nobody's happy about his loss. We always get told that we're almost there. We're almost there. Like, me personally, I'm tired of being almost there. I'm tired of being, you know, just this close. I feel like I've been hearing it for so long now. But, at the end of the day, all you can do is get back to work. That's the only reaction you have.
Here are some stats to look at from the show. Now, the Bears' offense has now scored 10 or fewer points in the last three primetime contests dating back to last year. The team is also now 8-8 all-time on Thursday Night Football. One trend that continued was the Bears' inability to get the lead at the half, as they have now trailed at the break in all six games this season. But here is a little bit of a positive moment. Jaquan Brisker, he had a sack in the first quarter, becoming the Bears' first rookie defensive back with multiple sacks since the 2009 season. This is a picture that's been shared a lot on social media over the last 24 hours, and it pretty much perfectly sums up exactly what the Bears game was like on Thursday. There is Justin Fields, crouched down, his hand on his head, wondering how in the world the Bears failed to score on three red zone trips in the loss to the Commanders. Had they just gotten a few points on a few of those drives, the result would have totally been different. Now, it was a bad night on Soldier Field, but not everything was frustrating because a few very special survivors of breast cancer and those who are currently battling the disease were able to have their moment at the Bears game. As part of the Real Bears Fans Wear Pink initiative, a number of breast cancer patients and survivors took part in a few tributes either on the field or around the stadium as part of Breast Cancer Awareness Month. You heard about the effort from Advocate Healthcare yesterday on the 9-yard line, so we wanted to show you this tweet from Advocate of a few of the participants in the ceremony. As you can see, everybody there having a great time. And from Dr. Heidi Memel, who you heard from on the show yesterday, who treated a few of these patients who took part in the event on Thursday, she was part of the opening coin toss. A very special moment for her and all of those who are either breast cancer survivors or those who continue to battle the disease. Now, this weekend, you don't have a Bears game to watch, and you actually don't have one next Sunday either. That's because the Bears are playing on a Monday night in Week 7. They'll take the field against the Patriots on Monday, October 24th at Gillette Stadium in New England. It's the Bears' first visit to Foxborough since the 2014 season, when they lost to the eventual Super Bowl champs 51-23. Now, the Bears have never beaten the Patriots on their home field, going 0-4 all time, and haven't defeated them overall since they beat them at Soldier Field in 2000. Now, you can see that game right here on WGN TV Channel 9 at 7:15 p.m. That is the scheduled kickoff. WGN News will also have a preview show that will begin at 6:30. Well, that will do it for this edition of the 9-Yard Line. I'm Larry Hawley. For up-to-date Bears information, please go to WGNTV.com. But for now, have yourself a wonderful weekend, and we'll see if the Bears' results change when they go to New England here in about a week and a half. Take care, everyone. We'll be right back.